Hi everyone and welcome to the channel. In this video I'm going to finish the 3D printed model of Gollum I've been working on for the last couple of months, and I'm also going to wrap up the display and finally 3D print the ring and attach it to the model. So if you're interested in seeing how this project turns out, please stick around and see what happens. Before I proceed any further, I'm just going to display Gollum here as he is at the moment. I am actually very pleased with how he turned out. I have painted the model, painted the eyes, nails and all of the small details, added a bit of hair, which actually made him look really creepy. And I only need to finish the display down here below him. And as you can see, I have already done the woodwork. And if you're interested in how I did this, I have made the exact same display stand for my Terminator model, and in one of my previous videos I am actually showing how I did this, so check that out if you're interested in how I did this. For this video I will focus on how I'm going to build the landscape and all of the terrain around or below Gollum here. So the idea I have is that I am going to place some rocks. I'm going to make Gollum sit on a small piece of cliff, and then I'll have some water below here, like a small lake in a cave. And I'm going to make the water using resin, and I'm going to make the cliff using some styrofoam. And that will be the first task for today, to cut out all of the styrofoam that needs to be on the back of this. Then I'll have to paint it up, paint everything up, make it look like real rock. Then I'll add the resin as the water, the fake lake, and after that I will add all of the details, such as a bit of vegetation and small pebbles and whatever could create the atmosphere of a realistic environment. I have also considered adding some small artificial lights around the display, probably three small mini projectors that can cast different colors of light up on the model of Gollum himself, as I actually think that I can use these to create a very nice atmosphere and use the light to create the illusion of him being in a damp and dark cave. So I am going to do that too. Finally, I am going to attach the one ring. As you can see, he is prepared for it. He's sitting right here, and there's room enough for the ring. So I'm going to 3D print the ring in resin, and then paint it up, make it look like real gold, and then attach it between his fingers here. So I am going for a look where I am raising him a bit from the base, as I actually think this model is a bit low, and that's almost a shame. I think I can get a lot more attention to the model if I raise him just a tiny bit up here, for example, on this rocky surface. So the rock will be raised a fair amount of space, as this will give a lot more attention to Gollum himself. But that was basically the plan. So now I'm just off to work, and I'll start by cutting some of the blue styrofoam and make it fit on the back here, and then I will add all of the rock texture on it after that. Please enjoy. That's it. I'm all set to start the work on the terrain for Gollum. I have marked where I want the cliff and the water to be on the display, and I have acquired some blue insulation foam I can use to create the rock he's standing on. It's going to be several layers of this, and I'm just going to cut it out with a hobby knife as possible, because that's one of the main features of this blue foam, that I can actually cut it with a hobby knife. I have decided to do the project in here, as I have a smooth floor, so it'll be pretty easy to clean up, because this is going to make a small mess when I start cutting in this, especially if I'm going to use a saw. So I'm just going to start by marking up on this one where it will fit on the display, and then cut it out and attach it, and then do all of the layers. Well, that was actually a lot of hobby knife use, and as you can see on the floor, there are several small pieces of this blue foam down here. But one of the main advantages of using blue foam for a project like this is that you can actually cut it using a common hobby knife. If you're using a standard insulation material, the white stuff, and you try to cut it with a hobby knife, it will completely disintegrate and become all of these small pieces that are flying around everywhere. But this blue foam, you can actually make clean cuts, such as these over here, and that's absolutely one of the main advantages of using this material. It's a bit more expensive, but when working with projects like this, it's completely worth the money. Now, I only need to wait for this to dry. I have used a common PLA glue to glue all of this together, and this will have a drying time of around 24 hours before I can proceed. The next step is that I'm going to take a rock, and then I'm going to roughen up all of these surfaces so I don't have all of these nice smooth surfaces. They are not very cliff-like. But this ended up looking pretty good, and I'm sure that it will end up looking like a rock when I'm finished with it. I'm just going to use all of the time I have at my hands right now to make the ring. I have uncovered my old Anycubic Photon printer over here, and I'm going to 3D print the one ring in resin, as it offers a lot more details. So I'm just going to find a 3D model I can use, and then I'm going to do the ring. Yeah, it's about time to do the ring for Gollum and start getting the project wrapped up. And to do that, I'm just going to do a quick search on Thingiverse on Gollum. As you might have noticed if you saw some of my previous episodes of this build, you saw that I used this Gollum model, which is a very nice model, and it's in here for free, and please support the creator by downloading and building his model. That's a great, great model. But I thought that the ring lacked a bit. It was very plain, it was basically just a solid ring, and I thought that I wanted to do this model with a bit more detail. And luckily, when I just searched on Gollum here, the one ring, this 3D model, popped up, and if we just take a look at it here, we can see that it actually has all of the inscriptions. So I think this ring will suit my purpose much better. So I'm just going to download this and upload it into my slicer and make it look like gold. It's time to slice the ring. So I have opened up my slicing software, and as you can see, I have the ring model here I downloaded on Thingiverse just before, and there are a lot of different editions of the ring here. All are based on size differences, and I measured a bit on the Gollum model, and I estimated that the ring needed to be around 22-23 millimeters, so I'm going for one of these. I actually don't know exactly what the second number here means, so I'm just going to go for this one and see how it looks when I open it in the slicer. And this actually looks pretty good. So I'm going to go for this model. This is the one ring with inscription. So now I just need to add some support. I generally always add support to my models, as I think that gives the best result, and even though I don't think it's necessarily needed on this one, I'm going to do it anyway. It's pretty easy to remove the supports down here on the edge of a ring like this. So it's just a bit of sandpaper, and then it's completely clean. I often overdo the supports a bit, just to make sure that it doesn't leave the build plate. That's pretty annoying when it happens. So I'm just going to add a lot of extra supports here. As I said before, it's very easy to remove. And when all of these has been added, I'm going to slice it and send it to the printer. Ah, that should probably do it. One ring to rule them all.
So this is how the base looks after I have glued all the pieces of foam together, and now I only need to make or create some texture in the surface of this, so it will end up looking a bit more like rock, because this isn't very rock-like. So to do that, I have found a couple of rocks in our courtyard, and a rock like this will be perfect, and I'm going to take this one and simply press it down really hard in this surface to create this texture. And I'm going to do this everywhere on this display or this base to give it this final rock-like surface. And that's probably going to take some time. So I'm just going to do that now, and then make a small video of it when I have finished. That's how my cliff turned out after texturing it using a rock. And this actually looks pretty good. It's a bit banged up, it has a lot of depth. You can see all of these small cracks and surface texture on top of all of this blue foam, and it actually looks very nice. So now I only need to apply a thinned PVA glue to all of this to make sure that the pieces that has broken off when I mold this with a rock will actually stay in place. And then I'm going to allow it to dry for about 24 hours, and then I'll start painting it. But this is how it turned out. There is no way actually of saying how it will end up looking right now when it's completely finished. There are a lot of steps involved in this, but as it looks now, I'm very satisfied. So I think this will turn out great. Well, my awesome scenic sprayer here just died while applying a layer of glue to all of my nice rock surface here. And that's actually a bit of a shame, as I'm going to need it later in this project. But if I'm very lucky, I can order a new one and actually get it here before I need it. Because I'm going to need it when I'm going to apply flock and rock to all of this. But before I can get to that step, I'll have to paint all of this up. And that's actually a very awesome technique. And I'm going to start by painting it all white, and I'm going to do that tomorrow. So this needs to be completely dry before I can do that. Well, I have finally gotten to the part where I can start priming this base and painting it up like real rock. And the idea is that I want to create this effect of making it look like a real rock. So it's going to look, or I hope I can get it to look, a bit like this, just a bit more gray. So we are going for a mix of this one and this one. So a bit between those. And to do that, I'll start by priming off this white. And that might seem like a strange idea, priming it white, but it works really well when I'm working with dioramas and model railways and so on. So I have never tried it on such a scale like this, but I'm just going to see what happens and try it. And if it doesn't work, then I'll just repaint it. It's as easy as that. So I found this prime color here, primer, easy or cheap paint. And then I'm just going to apply a layer of white all over this stuff. Another advantage of this is that this blue foam, it isn't very resistant to spray paints. So if I'm going to spray paint anything, I simply need there to be a layer of paint on top of it, because it will make this disappear. It'll simply erode it or corrode it. I don't know what it's called in English, actually. It will disintegrate it, when spraying on it. So the paint will also protect against that if I decide to use any spray paints, which I'm probably going to do. So let's just begin and apply the primer. Yeah, I just decided to paint this up without the camera and then take some videos and pictures of it when I had finished the white priming. And this is how it ended up looking. I have primed everywhere, and I needed to apply some primer inside all of these small gaps up here between all of these foam blocks. And I couldn't get the brush in there, so I used a spray primer and simply sprayed inside the holes, and that turned out really nice. So now I need this to dry completely, because the next process I need to use some very wet thinned down glue and let the glue flow over all of the surfaces down by itself. So this needs to be 100% dry before I can do that, or else the process will fail, and I wouldn't want that. So I'm just going to leave this for at least a day, maybe even two, to make sure that it has dried up 100%, a completely dry layer of paint, and then I can hopefully proceed and get the result I want. Here we have it, the white rock, ready for paint. It took 2 entire days for this to dry up, and of course it's because this room we're in right now is pretty cold, so I had to take a heater in use just to dry it up yesterday and make sure that it was ready for today. It's weekend, so I really hope I can finish this project during the next couple of days. I have prepared some paints for this. I'm going to make all of this white stuff look like a real rock, and that is actually kind of a challenge. I have done it before on a much lesser scale in a diorama, and I found a guide on YouTube made by Luke from Geek Gaming Scenics, and I really like the way he does this, and there are some awesome guides on his channel. So if you like making dioramas and working with miniatures and terrain, then you should definitely check out his channel. The general way of doing this is that I have taken an ochre paint here, a yellowish paint, and thinned it very much with water. And then I'm going to apply it over about 1/3 of all of this white rock surface. Then I have a corresponding brown paint that has been thinned, and I'm going to apply that to around 1/3 of this rock surface. Then I have a very thinned brown I'm going to apply over all of it. When that is done, I'm going to leave it to dry, and I'm probably going to take that heater in use. And finally, I'm going to apply a watered down black paint and apply it to everything. And when that has dried, I might be have to apply a second layer. But when it's dry, it should look like a real rock with the color differences in between the gray. And I did it on diorama, it worked really well. I haven't done it on a foam surface before. Last time it was on a plaster surface of a cast rock. But let's see how it goes, that's the way of doing it. And I really hope this will turn out to look like a natural rock, because that's the idea. I don't want it to look like a model, I want it to look like a real rock. So let's just get started. This might take some time, and once again there might be some drying involved. So the faster I can do it, the better. Yeah, that's it. First couple of layers applied, and as you can see, this looks absolutely terrible. It actually looks like someone has vomited on top of it. But when this is complete, it's going to look incredible. or at least my previous experience tells me that it's going to look incredible. Right now it's kind of hard believing in it, but I am positive and I'm trying to get the best out of it, and I'm pretty sure that it will turn out like it did last time. Last time I did this was on a diorama, as I have said previously, and on that diorama I used cast pieces of plaster that looked like rock surface, and the advantage of the plaster is that it sucks in the paint and makes it dry very quickly. This is foam, and there is absolutely no drying of the paint in this foam. As you can see here, it's just laying here in puddles of the paint, and that's actually kind of a problem because I need this to dry, and I need it to dry fast because this is just the first layer I have to apply. After this, I'll have to apply a brown layer, a brown wash on top of it all, a very thin down. Then that needs to dry, and then I'll need to apply a black wash on top of it all, and that also needs to dry. And it has to be finished today if I am going to have any chance of doing this diorama or this base for Gollum during this weekend. So I have taken a heater in use again, and I'm actually not quite sure that it's enough, but I'm hopeful. So I'm leaving this to dry, and then I just hope that it will dry very quickly. While we just wait for this to dry up, I'm going to show you something over here. This is my 3D printing station, and over here in or by my Enders, I have some of these. I thought a bit about how I could enhance the base for Gollum, because if you don't do anything about it and just make it in rock and then a bit of water and then place Gollum on it, it's actually going to look a bit boring. Even though it's a great model and the base has, I've added a lot of work to the base, it's still going to look a bit boring. So always try to add a bit of detail. It doesn't have to be very much, but just a tiny bit of detailing to it will really make a difference. And it gives people something to look at when they're looking at the base. They'll have to use their eyes and they'll have to search the base to see if they can find any of these details. So I've decided on one of the things, some mushrooms. And I have this printable model here. I've printed them on these Enders. I have someone that's a bit wider here, smaller, and I even have printed some larger ones. And I'm going to paint these ones up and place them around on the display for Gollum, to give it a bit of detail. I am probably also going to make some vegetation, some green colors, because the base is very gray due to all of the rock surface. So it's always a great idea to use some colors that's a bit in contrast, that will stand out from the base itself to make people find it inspiring. And I have decided to add a bit of vegetation to it when it's finished. Just a tiny bit, not too much, never overdo it. But these are the mushrooms, and I'm going to paint these ones up and then add them to the base. And beside these, I have been printing the ring Gollum is going to sit with, and I think this is an excellent time just to take a look at it. I think I put it in here somewhere. And this ring is a bit more detailed than the one that followed with the Gollum model. So it actually has all of the inscriptions. I don't know if it's possible to see here with the camera. Let's see if I can get it fixed or locked on. Yeah, you might be able to see the inscriptions here. That should be much more visible when I have painted it up. And this is actually a great time to paint this ring up, as all of the other parts are standing there and just drying. So I'll have to make this look like real gold, and that should be another challenge in the project. So I'll continue with that right now. To save a bit of time, I have decided to paint all of these small details while I wait for the display to dry. There are a lot of wet paint on it, and it will take a long time for it to be completely dry. So let's work a bit on this. I have made these small mushrooms, which will be positioned inside the cave where Gollum is standing, and these are actually from a Kickstarter I pledged on a long time ago, and I'll add a link in the description below so you can find them for yourself. They are actually pretty nice. These are called cave mushrooms, which suits my purpose very, very well. I have printed them in PLA on an Ender 3 Pro printer, and the surface You can see it's actually a very smooth surface I have up here. I actually printed them in a very low resolution with a massive layer height. And then I got this surface so smooth using UV curing resin. I applied to the top and then I cured it, and that simply removed all of the layer lines. So I got this very clean finish. I'm going to paint these in a light brown color so they will stand out a bit from the rocky surface of the cliff, but they will still look like they actually belong. If we're taking a look at the ring then, we can see I have printed the one ring here. This is the one Gollum is going to sit with between his fingers. I have checked the size and it fits. And if we just take a look here, I don't know if we can get the camera to focus. There it is. You can see all of the inscription here. This actually turned out really well. This has been printed on an Anycubic Photon, and this is a very nice result. The main idea here is to make this look like real gold, and to do that I am going to use this Vallejo liquid gold paint and see how that turns out. I have actually never used this before, but sometimes you just gotta try and see what happens. So that's what I'm about to do now, let's just start painting all of this up. This is about as dry as it's going to get, so I need to seal off all of the paint and then apply the black wash. And to seal it, I would usually use a scenic sprayer such as this with a thinned down PVA glue, but this is drying time, so I'm just going to put this away. I haven't got time to wait on that, and I know I've said before that you must never rush a project, but I am actually in a lot of hurry here. I need to finish this before the weekend, and away with that. And instead I found this basic rattle can with a matte varnish, and I'm pretty sure this can do the job. But there are some advantages and some disadvantages of rattle cans. One of them is that they are highly flammable, and as I have a heating block over here, or heating with heating elements in here, I'm pretty sure this could cause a small explosion if any of this stuff got in there. And I would never hear the end of that story if I should blow up my Gollum project. So I'm just going to turn this off and put it far away before proceeding with the project. Well, this looks pretty good, and it has a really nice rock-like effect, but there are some places where I would really like it to be a bit more grey or grey rockish. So I'm going to overspray all of this with a rattle can with a dark grey color. And I'm just going to be very gentle with it because I actually like the feel of this as it is, but it still just needs that tiny bit, that tiny touch of grey. So I'm going to add that using a rattle can. Yeah, that's so much better. This is like I wanted it to look like, a bit more grey than before. Right now it's still shining because I just applied it, but when this dries up it will become matte and will look much, much better. I'm also under artificial light right now, and in real sunlight this will look so much better. So I need to apply all the small details now, and that's actually one of the most fun parts of doing a diorama or base like this. I really enjoy that. So I've made these small mushrooms here. I'm going to place them around it for a nice effect, and I'm going to apply some of these small rocks here and some flock and everything just to make it look as real as possible. So I'm very satisfied with it so far. So just start applying those so they can dry until tomorrow. It's beginning to get a bit late. Well, that's it for today. I have sealed off all of the paint, the flock, and the smaller rocks I have applied. So now there's only one thing left to do, and that's once again just wait until this dries, and then I can continue with the project tomorrow. I still need to do the water down here, and I think that will just put a nice finish to it. So when that's finished, I'm going to take a look at some vegetation up here, might add a bit of plants and so on. A bit of green might not hurt, but I'm still considering what to do. So yeah, I'll just take a look at that tomorrow. No need to make any decisions right now, as I'm pretty tired. This simply looks amazing. This is just how I imagined it. I have the vegetation, I have some mushrooms, I've added some dark blue color down here where I'm going to apply some transparent resin to create the effect of water, and the rock looks really great. There's only one thing left to do, and that's use some pigments to enhance and create a bit more depth in all of the stone or rocky surface. So that's what I'm going to do now. During the entire project, I've been running around and saying that I wanted to use UV resin for the water effect. And after a bit of research, I discovered that this stuff is much, much cheaper. This is a two-component styrene where you have the styrene and then you have a hardener. And when you apply this to this, this will harden up and become very strong. and this creates a very nice water effect. So I'm going to use this instead, and I'm just going to start puring it on the landscape and see how it turns out. My bet is that it's going to look really great, because these water effects always improve the quality of a diorama or landscape. So let's just start puring. Well, I have finished Gollum now, and I'm very satisfied with how he turned out. I am very satisfied with the base. Just look at that, the reflection in the water and everything. This just looks amazing. And the ring, I still need to attach the ring. I have it right here on the floor at the moment. I have the ring right here, and that also turned out really great. It looks like gold, it has all of the inscriptions, and it's going to look awesome when he's sitting with it in his hands. But there's one thing that I'm not very satisfied with, and that's these mini protectors. I actually think they destroy the overall look of the entire model. I already removed the two I've positioned on the back, and I'm also going to remove these two. This model is going to be standing without any kind of electronics, artificial light, and so on. This is just going to be a 3D printed model of Gollum, hand painted with a ring, and then this base that is completely handmade out of foam, flock, and paints, and the water, epoxy. This, I think this looks really great, and it will look much better without all of these artificial lights. So I'm going to remove those now, and then I'm going to fix up all of the damages on the side, and then it's complete. Here we have him, my finished version of Gollum, complete with the ring and a display. And I'm just taking a quick look here around him and showing you how he looks. I am really proud of this project. He turned out very, very nice indeed. I am so satisfied with how the 3D printed model of Gollum turned out. I am very satisfied with how the ring turned out. I might want to do a bit more with the fingernails and make them look better. That was probably a bit too quickly painted, but I can still manage to do that. And I think the eyes turned out really nice. And the hair makes him look extremely creepy, so that's perfect. And then down here below him, we have this hand-built scenic base, which I have used a lot of time on making, and that looks absolutely great. This is a blue foam painted like rock, with a bit of flock and a bit of vegetation, some mushrooms, and finally we have the water down here, which Gollum even cast a reflection in. So personally, I think this is one of my better projects this year, and I'm very proud of it. I did a lot of work on the veins here, so he looked so they could be seen, and I think he looks really great. Probably going to place him in some different lights to see how that will affect the overall look of him, but I'm very satisfied with this result. This looks awesome. Yeah, that's it. I finally finished Gollum, and he turned out really great. This is the first model I have printed on the CR10 Max, and he's incredible. I really adore this model. This turned out so great. I'm really happy about it. So I really hope you enjoyed watching the video and that you have learned something from it. And
Please consider subscribing to the channel if you can use it for something, or if you're interested in watching more videos from me. I have a lot of projects planned. And remember to hit the like button for this little fellow here. He could certainly use it, because we all know he's going to lose that ring, and that's actually a bit sad for him. He's a very sad character. So thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and have a nice day.